Maybe you are wondering what an old man is doing here on the stage, addressing mga millennials. Now, some of you could be my grandchildren already, no? Well, basically because the president appointed me as the acting secretary of the Department of Information and Communication Technology. Alam niyo, ang presidente matanda rin kasi katulad ko. But, mayroon kami may ipakita sa mga kabataan na because we have experience na siguro hindi nyo pa na-experience. Now, for example, when I took the first electronics and communication engineering way back in 1971, sino sa inyong na panganak na noon? Ang pinakaunang ECE board examination. Ang mga questions noon, what is a pentode? Sino sa inyo nakakalam kung what is a pentode? I-Google nyo. Mga trial. So, ito actually are non-existent anymore, no? But in our profession, we have to acquaint ourselves to the very fast development of ICT. I became the first NTC, National Telecommunication Commissioner, of the present Speaker of the House when she was President GMA. No? And noon, there were only two telcos, mobile telcos. Of course, you know, Globe and Smart. That was in the year 2001. So you notice na noon, ano yung pinaka-killer application during that time? Texting, SMS. Tayo ang pinaka-texting capital of the whole world. We were texting 1.4 billion text messages a day. No? Who of you remember that time? Yung mga Nokia pa yung mga cellphone natin? Okay, may mga konting old-timers dito, no? By the way, ang tawag sa inyo, millennials, alam mo tawag sa generation namin? Baby boomers. Mga baby boomers kami, no? Maganda, mas maganda pakinggan yung generation namin kaysa sa millennial. Bakit baby boomers? I-Google nyo ulit. No? So yun, there were two, alam nyo na, Golden Spark, 2001, sila ang pinakamalaking mobile providers natin. That time, there were only less than 10 million subscribers, no? 10 million na mayroong Nokia o yung 2G natin, tinatawag natin 2G, no? Kaya magpaparaffle kami ng 2G. Sino mo itisado magkaroon ng 2G phone? Ha? Okay. Bakit more or less, alam niyo when Jack Ma was here a few months ago at ginagamit na natin ay itong mga tinatawag na smartphone, 3G, 4G at papunta na tayo sa 5G. Anong sabi ni Jack Ma nung he addressed a young audience just like you in a school. Ano sabi niya, the first thing I did when I arrived in this country was to test the internet speed. It was no good. Totoo ba yan? So, ang department na responsibilidad niyan is my department. Kaya, no good din kami siguro. But, we are 10 years old, no, in department. And, yung progress ng ating ICT, is, as I said, we started with 2, low and smart. Naipasok ko noon ang SAN, digital, no? When I was NTC commissioner, way back in 2001. So, yung dalawa nagkaroon ng competition. Ako ang nag-advise sa Gokong Wei, kay Mr. Gokong Wei, who owns digital at SAN. Alam mo kung gusto mong mag-compete with Global Smart, within your network, unlimited call, unlimited text ka. Because sa network mo, kung isa lang magamit, at million-million, pareho lang yung operating expenses mo. So he did that. So, nagkaroon tayo ng unlimited and nag-object in Global Smart, sabi nila, unfair competition daw yun. But we stood fast. Na hindi unfair competition yan because it will benefit the consumer. And soon enough, pati Global Smart nag-unli na rin. So kaya mayroon na tayong unli ngayon. But that is not the case. We still have the slowest internet connection in the region and at the same time, may number one raw tayo, the most expensive. No? So, we have, as my department, we are tasked by our president to take care of that. So, ano yung mga programa namin? And this is addressed to all the young audience here, because we would like to improve our luck in ICT from one in the bottom to at least reaching yung pinakamahusay ngayon sa dito natin, which is Singapore. No? So let me start with the mandate of the ICT. Okay, the current state now is that we have 8.6 million unemployed Filipinos. That much. Sino dito employed? The problem with us is that yung pinag-aaralan natin ngayon may not be available when we graduate. Itong anong pinaka employment na nag-click sa atin? Yung BPO, di ba? Call centers. But do you know that the IT BPO is being challenged by artificial intelligence? Ang servisyo natin sa BPO is mostly voice services, no? Calling or answering calls coming from all over the world who are at binibigyan natin sila ng information on the questions that they ask, no? So yun lang ang ating plan. That's why pinipili nila for a BPO agent yung mahusay mag-English, and that is particularly our advantage. Our way of speaking English made us overtook India in the voice service in the BPO industry. But voice service is now being challenged by artificial intelligence. No? Sometimes when you talk to a company, you think you are talking to a person, when actually you might be talking to a robot. Ang voice recognition, ito ngayon ang nasa artificial intelligence. So imagine, yung ating IT BPO, which is now the number 2 dollar earning industry in our country, might be challenged soon enough by artificial intelligence. So kayo na nagpapalak pumasok sa call centers, baka we really have to do something for this dollar earner in our country. Ano po ito? We will use artificial intelligence to fight artificial intelligence. How do we do that? Kayo, mga estudyante, for example, kung may open notes examination at pinayagan kayo to Google in that examination, sino palagay nyo dito ang babagsak? Kung mag-Google nyo yung mga questions ng examination, that is artificial intelligence being used. No? Kaya nga pa namin ngayon eh, siguro pasawaan, hindi na dapat close notes ang mga examination. Dapat bigyan natin ang mga kabataan the initiative to have their notes open. Kasi ganyan na po ang mundo natin, no? Yung ating mind can only accommodate so much facts. Pero dito sa ating cellphone, narito lahat lang facts na makapagsagot ng kahit na pinakamahirap na examination sa buong mundo. So siguro we are now trying to talk with the DepEd na maybe we must teach our students how to maximize the use of ICT. Noon, okay, open books, kaya mo pupunta ka sa isang examination ng ibang kapal ang books mo, no? To cover all subjects na pwedeng bumaba sa examination. Pero ngayon, dito na lang kailangan mo. So why not have our youth create that initiative na pwede lahat ng answers na pwede ibigay sa kanya, pwede niya kagad hanapin. Because with that, kahit na yung BPO natin, kung may question na darating sa atin, pwede natin kagad kung mabilis tayo magkuha yung answer sa internet, and then we just press a button at yung lalabas hindi yung boses mo, kundi a very perfectly, grammatically correct answer na binigay ng artificial intelligence. So that way, we can use artificial intelligence to fight artificial intelligence. So ito yung mga pwede namin or kailangan mag-shift na tayo from putting all facts in your mind when in fact the skill to look for it in the internet is what we should be developing. So yun, isa yun. Of course, may challenge dito. Sino wala pang cellphone dito? Yung totoo lang, ha? So, tanungin nyo, okay. In fact, isa sa mga aming program is to bring down the cost of ICT devices. No? Para sa lahat ng eskwelahan, libre na kayo ng tuition, no? Pero yung mga gamit ng estudyante so that they can really appreciate the use of ICT, mga tablets, mga laptop, ito dapat ay kailangan ma-experience ng natin mga estudyante natin. No? Because we are supposed to prepare you for the future. No? So how can you prepare yourself for the future kung yung tools that will be available to us for the future ay hindi nyo experience in this event. No? So let's start with what we can afford. No? Pero all of that, yung sinasabi ko ngayon, are all useless kung wala tayong magandang connectivity sa internet. No? Kung mabagal yung ating pag-access ng internet, ay all of that will be not going to work. So we have a national broadband plan. Ito itagad yung aming when we became a department, ito pagkat ang aming maging isang malaking program to make internet accessibility in this country fast and inexpensive. No? Ngayon, nalawalang telcos ang nagbibigay sa atin ng internet connectivity. So marami tayong ISPs. No? Pero lahat yan, konektado sa dalawang telco lang, Golden Smart. Dahil sila lang ang may international gateway facilities that brings, that connects us outside the country. So, for the first time, the government, we had a tripartite agreement with Facebook, BCDA, and DICT, so that we will have what we call the Luzon Bypass Infrastructure. Na gagamitin ito ng Facebook to bypass yung tinatawag nating Luzon Strait. No? What is wrong with the Luzon Strait? Halos lahat ng submarine cable na galing from United States, Canada, the Americas, papunta sa Asia, pass through the Luzon Strait, no? The area between Luzon, Northern Luzon, and Taiwan. Mga 21 na submarine cable na dumadaan dyan. Ano ang problema dyan? Because almost every year, in fact, dumadaan dyan ang bagyo, ang kapitas sa hahagumpong na dunduman. And yung strait na yan suffers earthquake, no? So, every year, may napuputol dyan na submarine cable. Ngayon, Facebook, they have a very huge capacity submarine cable from Los Angeles going to Hong Kong. Dumadaan dyan ngayon. Napuputulan po sila. Kaya, gusto nilang i-bypass yun and dadaan sa Luzon to sa Aurora, Balian Aurora, facing the Pacific, and sa Puro Point facing the South China Sea. We will connect that with about a 250-kilometer fiber cable, no? Sa land na ito. So kahit na maputol yung Facebook doon sa Luzon Strait, mayroon sila kaagad na palipas. And they can take their time to fix yung kaputulan na kable nila. It takes about 1 month to 2 months to fix a broken cable and a seat at Mahal. With that, they will give us 2 terabits internet capacity. 2 terabits is about as much as what Globe. And Globe is about 3.4 terabits ang kanilang capacity. And this one, ito yung bakit mas mabilis at mas mura itong ating napirmahan with Facebook. Remember the internet bandwidth cost in Los Angeles is less than $1 per megabit per month. Sa ganun din sa Hong Kong, no? We did not pay anything for the submarine cable. Unlike Globe and Smart, mayroon din sila ganyan, but they have to invest in that submarine cable, no? So, kahit na nakukuha nila yung internet capacity from Hong Kong, let's say at about 80 cents per megabit per month, pagdating dito, nagiging $5 per megabit per month. Pero atin, since hindi tayo nagbayad sa Facebook for that submarine cable, pagdating dito, it will have the same cost as in Hong Kong. And also, it will have the same cost as in Los Angeles, yung landed cost dito sa Pilipinas. Isa pa, Globe and Smart put up a backbone. No, para ma-distribute nila itong internet connectivity all over the Philippines. Pero itong hindi sila nag-share. Nagtayo ang Globe ng sarili, nagtayo rin ang Smart ng sarili na. Kaya pagdating sa Mindanao, the internet cost there is already about 40 to 50 US dollars per megabit per month. And that is why we have one of the most expensive internet costs here in this country. But pagdating dito sa kanya, we were able to also sign an MOU with Transco NGCP. Itong Transco is our national electric grid, no? Pero mayroon silang dark fiber that they use for their monitoring systems, SCADA. But this can also be used by telecommunication companies. So, ito'y binigay at pinapagamit sa gobyerno, sa DICT na libre. So, in effect, we can send the cost of Hong Kong, the cost in Los Angeles, down to Mindanao, na walang patong. So with that, we can bring down the cost of our internet. And this is going to be operational by the end of next year, 2019. And therefore, kaya nga sinasabi namin, ang vision namin is 2020. Short-term vision, wherein by year 2020, not ito, ay mararamdaman na ng ating mga kababayan, even as far as Mindanao. And of course, by that time, may third telco na tayo. No? May third telco na tayo na more or less may advantage ng third telco. Kahit na sila ay wala pang... Ang subscribers ng Globe and Smart is already 130 million between the two of them. Mas marami pa nga isa sa populasyon ng Pilipinas. No? It's only 105. Because most of us have 2 SIM, or 2 cell phones. So, itong new telco, ang advantage niya is it doesn't have any excess luggage. It does not have any legacy equipment, no? Yung Globe and Smart, may 2G pa sila. And there are about 30 million 2G subscribers in this country. 2G is now phased out in South Korea, wala na yan sa Hong Kong, wala na yan sa Singapore. In fact, it, by next year have spaced out na yan sa region natin except the Philippines. Pero itong third telco can go ahead leapfrog to 5G. So, we will have the 5G activated here in our country and it will make yung speed natin very fast and very less expensive, no? So, kung kayo ay graduate na next year, siguro magpabagsak muna kayo para pag-graduate nyo, mabilis na yung internet natin, no? Hindi na, I'm just joking. Free Wi-Fi. Itong free Wi-Fi, we have already 1,500 free Wi-Fi access points all over the country. But our target is that by the end of 2022, we will have more than 100,000 free Wi-Fi. Sa ngayon, pumunta lang kayo ng Luneta, may free Wi-Fi doon. And yung speed doon is no less than 4 megabits per second. Because we now have a free Wi-Fi law, no? RA-10-929. That mandates the ICT to put up free Wi-Fi in all public places in the Philippines. No? So ito po, we will put free Wi-Fi in all public schools, in all state-owned universities and colleges, mga munisipyo, mga parks, basta mayroong mga taong gathering in a point, may free Wi-Fi yung lalagay tayo doon. And it will be fast and of course, free. But itong connectivity will all be useless kung wala akong content. No? The one driving ICT is not only the infrastructure, but most importantly, yung content. Dahil dito ang buhay ng ICT. No? Wala, anong gamit dito kung wala kayong Facebook? Anong gamit dito kung walang Google? No? So yung content. And that one is a government common platform. So ito, that was discussed by the speaker before me. Yung content na yun ay di-develop. Yun ang inasa namin that will come from you. No? Kayo ang future Bill Gates. Kayo ang future FB developer. No? Yan ang kailangan natin sa bansa na ito. Because sa ngayon, lahat ng content natin, Uber, WhatsApp, Viber, Facebook of course, saan nagagaling ang mga servers nito? Wala sa Pilipinas, no? Nasa labas ng Pilipinas. So if we can put our own content dito sa ating bansa, develop by ng people like you, ang laking that is a big development that you can give to our country. And you can do it, no? You can do it. And that is a challenge from an old man to you. Kasi kayo ang hope itong bansa ito. Soon, wala na kami, but you will be still here. You're just laying the ground so that when you are capable, mabilis na internet natin, mura na, and therefore you can work your heart's content in coming up with applications, programs, games that will be useful to your fellow citizens. So itong panito, countryside development. Sa ngayon, all our BPOs are concentrated in urban areas. No? But do you know now, we have now tech for ed. Doon sa pinaka rural areas sa Sultan Kodarat, where people we put up connectivity, yun importante, connectivity first, and people then are actually now earning US dollars teaching English to Korean. So may bago kami term sa OFW, dati OFW is Overseas Filipino Workers. Ngayon hindi na po, you can earn dollars as an online Filipino worker. So yun ang natin pinapairal, and you don't really have to go to a urban areas where there are the big BPO agencies. You can do it at your home. You can do it in your community. So ICT, no? Itong mga challenge sa inyo. Anong number, anong two main cause ng traffic sa Metro Manila? Students going to school and people going to work. Hindi ba ito'y pwedeng i-alleviate through ICT? We don't have to be physically present to do work. Huh? We don't have to be physically present in the classroom to learn. If we have good connectivity, if we have fast connectivity, if we have inexpensive connectivity. So ito po yung aming programa. And then yung my empowerment, then I think I said mga content, mga application that in your imaginative mind pwede nyo i-develop. Pwede nyo i-develop. At I know in this hall right now, there are future buildings na who are here. Okay, yung Philippine Startup Challenge, yun na, this is addressed to the youth. We are going to finance whatever startup on ICT that you are going to develop. So, next slide please. And therefore, what can you contribute? Well, I think the answer is obvious. First, participate. Participate in a way that you are productive. Huwag lang kayo pumunta sa internet just to look for a boyfriend or a girlfriend. Huwag kayo pumunta sa internet to chat or worse, to bully people. No? Use the internet productively. Then contribute whatever talent you have. Initiate and innovate. No? These are the action of the youth. No? These are your challenges. So, nasa inyong kamay or nasa inyong fingertips ang future ng Pilipinas. So, I think that ends my presentation. Maraming salamat po. Mabuhay ang kabataan! Mabuhay ang pag-asa ng bayan! Thank you.
Sir Rios, thank you so much. Kindly remain on stage. Perhaps the biggest takeaway siguro, sir, ng mga college students natin, yung open notes and the free Wi-Fi, but of course, in the end, para mag-Facebook, mag-Instagram, but to be able to maximize the technology, to be able to retrieve information. Thank you so much, Sir Rio, but I believe our co-host, Micah, is with someone that wants to ask a question for you, sir. Micah?
Hi, Alex, and hi, sir. So please state your name and your university.
Hello, good morning. My name is Sanika Antenet Hefter from Arellano University, Jose Abad Santos Campus. So, good morning, sir. The topic was very interesting because it's government for the youth. And you said earlier that you want the youth to experience the ICT of today. So, my question is, How or what will the plan of the government to deliver the information communication technology to the youth living in the remote or rural areas, especially in Mindanao, when the branch of government couldn't deliver the good or proper education for them?
Thank you very much for that question. Yes, that is exactly the challenge that my department is facing. 40% of our country is either underserved or unserved by the commercial telcos. Kung talaga kayo outside of Manila, even going to Batangas for example, there will be spots there na walang signal what are going smart. Kaya minsan, that is the reason why we are carrying two cell phones, no? Kung walang signal isa. But that is a poor reflection of our ICT industry. So itong ginagawa ng bansa is, ang ginagawa ng gobyerno is itong program na ito is to have those 40% unserved and underserved areas be taken in the mainstream, no? In other words, yung pangangaling dapat ibuhos yung ating capacity to increase the internet. No? And that way, yung mga tao sa urban areas will now go out of the Manila, for example, be congested in Metro Manila. Kasi even if they are now in so-called mga outlying areas, they can still come up with the livelihood, no? That in fact will earn them more money than when they stay in Metro Manila. Ito may tinasabi namin, ito yung program namin, yung sinasabi, OFW, Online Filipino Workers. Ang dami nyo yan, you just need to create your own. Ito na nangyayari ng ating ICT. You can create your own business. You can create your own life. You can dictate your own destiny. No? With, kaya nga itong fourth industrial revolution, importante yung information. Because dito ngayon, aandar ang economy ng bansa on your ability to use information as a livelihood.
Alright, thank you so much, sir. Answering our question now, we'd like to call on Ms. Malibig, Sir Benny, and Ms. Dada to award Sir Rio a token of appreciation. Thank you so much.